Jubal Khan serves as the chapter master of the White Scars during the 41st millennium. As the second revered Astartes of his name, Jubal would be named the Great Khan during 943.M41 after succeeding his predecessor, Kublai Khan, following his disappearance fighting the Drukhari. Alongside two of his compatriots, Jubal would undergo the trials of the Storm Seers within the Valley of Khans at the base of the Kumkata Mountains. Surviving the trials alone, Jubal would never speak of his struggles he had faced to ascend as Master of the Fifth, yet his pedigree as a leader would be unimpeachable. Already a victor of countless battles, facing every manner of enemies to the Imperium, Jubal's deeds during the Jopal Uprising, following his rise to the rank of Chapter Master, would further cement his legacy as a brilliant strategist. Leading the White Scars during the Third War for Armageddon, with three brotherhoods at his command, the White Scars would be deployed among the deadlands of Armageddon. Jubal would order his lieutenant, Subodun Khan, to secure the planet's water and promethium processing stations, and prevent the Greenskins from damaging the planet's vital infrastructure. Leading his own men north to investigate the many orc structures being constructed within the region, Jubal's scouts would discover the orcs to be building shipyards filled with dozens of ramshackle void ships. Raiding the shipyard with kill teams, the White Scars would destroy many of the orc structures before the Xenos could react, yet be unable to destroy their infrastructure faster than the orcs could build. Fighting from building to building, progress would be slow. Despite pollution and grime congesting their bolters and vox grills, the White Scars would fight their way to the vast floating shantytowns built atop the Tempest Ocean of Armageddon. Destroying the remaining facilities set to construct new invasion craft, the White Scars would destroy an entire orc brigade alone, with no losses or a shot fired under the leadership of Jubal. Yet with Armageddon's slow reclamation by the Imperium, the White Scars' homeworld of Chogoris would be besieged. Huron Blackheart, Chaos Lord of the Red Corsairs, would invade the planet during the Great Khan's absence as the Second Brotherhood under the command of Buratai Khan staged a desperate defense to repel the invasion. Relieved with the arrival of the Third Brotherhood and their Master of the Hunt, kor'sarro Khan, the Red Corsairs would retreat. Furious at the tenacity of the Chaos Warband's actions, with the Great Khan's return, Jubal would lead a daring attack upon the space station of Sifnar as an act of vengeance against the Blood Reaver. Boarding the Starfort from multiple angles during their boarding actions, the White Scars would plant melter bombs across the station as Jubal Khan and his honor guard fought their way to the heart of the Sifnar. Trapped within the station's corridors, caused by damage to the station's plasma reactors, Jubal Khan would be imprisoned by the Red Corsairs and tortured for solar weeks. Launching an ambush against the ship wherein the Great Khan was imprisoned, the White Scars would liberate their lord, yet find him to be on the precipice of death. Returning to Chogoris, the White Scars would attend to Jubal Khan's wounds. Grievously crippled following his mutilations at the hands of the Red Corsairs, though Jubal Khan would live, he would be in no fit state to ever fight again. His indomitable spirit allowing his mind to orchestrate great strategies within a support cradle housed deep within the fortress monastery of Quan Zhao. The Great Khan, while still commanding his chapter, now entrusts the duty of war leader to kor'sarro Khan. Displeased with kor'sarro's transformation into a Primaris Space Marine following the Battle of Chogoris, Jubal nonetheless trusts the Master of the Hunt to fight in his stead, as his own physical confinement further sharpens his strategic brilliance, now absent of distractions. Bequeathing the Cyber Burkut, Anzug, to kor'sarro, the ancient Hawk of Fire and Water aids its new master in hunting the enemies of the chapter after eons of slumber. Imbued with the spirit of Chogoris through Anzug, and armed with the strategic brilliance of his Great Khan, kor'sarro leads the chapter in Jubal's name as they unleash their vengeance across the Yasan sector. Though for some among the chapter of the White Scars, they whisper that perhaps a warrior's death would be a kinder fate for the Great Khan.